Hi everyone. Ooh, it's cold here today, but I wanted to talk about something important, and that is fruit flies. What do I do about fruit flies? Well, first of all, in winter here in Toronto, where I'm currently living and I grew up, I don't experience much fruit flies. And for the past few years, I haven't been experiencing fruit flies even during spring or summer. And so, I mean, fruit flies love fruit. And I guess it's because I clean the fruit, all the fruit, before I, put them on my counter or store them on the floor. And that's what usually I do. And, even if I do get fruit flies, which I used to get a, sometimes quite a lot, that's fine. As long as it's not like big balls of fruit flies everywhere, like millions upon millions. But if you have just, a few dozen fruit flies, fruit flies don't hurt you. They don't hurt anyone. They don't cause any harm. And so you shouldn't cause harm to them. And I know there are some vegans that kill fruit flies. And if you're truly ethical and want to cause the least harm, then we don't kill fruit flies or cockroaches or stuff like and animals like that. But there are certain cases if you have infestation, if you have infestation, which basically, if you have like literally hundreds or thousands coming into your place, then you have to do something in order to not let that happen. And so you got to tackle the root of the cause, whatever the root of the cause is. Now, there are natural methods of catching these insects and releasing them outside. Now, sometimes it's not possible if you are living in an apartment, for example, and you live, let's say, on a high floor. You're not going to go all the way down to, and then all the way back up and all the way down and all the way back up, especially if you don't have a balcony in your apartment. And so sometimes it's unavoidable that we need to kill insects in order to protect ourselves and our home, but in most cases there are preventable methods and measures that we can take in order to not get into the situation of killing insects, because insects, all life is here for a reason. Cockroaches or what do they call aphids? No, they're like spiders and those centipedes and millipedes, they're here for a reason. And they come into the house because there are openings and there are cracks and they come in. And they have a purpose in this world, just like everywhere there's a purpose. And every being has a purpose. And so there are ways to deter these insects, but spiders are okay. I mean, I used to have this fear, like this arachnophobia fear of spiders and other, creepy crawlies. And eventually I just started to really feel love for all creatures. And love even for little insects that are around, and if they happen to be around. And I've seen this winter was pretty mild, and I've seen even during winter I've seen spiders crawling, and not a problem, And I find that when it comes to fruit flies or any insect, I don't worry about it. They don't harm anybody or anything. And people just don't like them for some reason and want to kill them or want to bag all their fruit or whatever. And, if we were in nature, we wouldn't be doing that, but then we'll be outside. But we shouldn't really be afraid of any of these. I mean, I used to kill them like fruit flies like crazy. I used to have that sticky tape, that hangs from the ceiling. And not anymore. I mean, I don't even experience it. I mean, I was living in Sherbrooke for a while, and I was living actually in a dirty, really dirty place because my roommates didn't clean. I did most of the cleaning, and then I just got fed up with cleaning after a while. And even in that state, there was no fruit flies, and there was no cockroaches, and there was nothing. And so it comes to a point where one understands the ethical side and causing the least harm. And once we understand that, we don't cause even the least, the harm to even ants, or at least we try not to. Flies and, flies, they don't really bother me as much. But there are, again, times when if a fly or a bee or wasp is in your house and your home, and you're sleeping, and it is affecting you, it's going in your ear, or just bothering you when you're sleeping, then unfortunately there are only so much that you can do. Sometimes there is a necessity, unfortunately, to kill the being, that fly or that bee, in order to get a good night's sleep, for example. And sometimes we have to do our best, like capture the being and then release that being outside, if possible. But sometimes it's not possible. And so we have to understand that the circumstance of the situation and try to do the best that we can to try to not cause harm to that being, or at least cause the least harm. And some people would say that I'm a hypocrite if I kill a fly that is probably unavoidable, or that is really not letting me go to sleep, or whatever the case may be. So each situation and each person in each place, there's different situations, and we cannot be totally perfect in every situation. And so that's my rambling on about fruit flies and other insects. And so just try to do your best, and I'll see you shortly. Take care, everyone, and much love.